Hey beautiful beings, welcome to video blog number 5. Today I want to talk a little bit about bullying, because I think that whether we're aware of it or not, there's likely some bullying in our lives, in our circles. There's for sure some bullying in our communities, and there's definitely bullying in our nation, be it from businesses or individuals. And I'll just start with a story. When I was in middle school, so going into sixth grade, I moved to Washington from Germany. And so, you know, the best time of life to move into middle school, right? And to be the new kid. And so not long into middle school, I started getting bullied by a few guys. And nothing terribly traumatic, but the effects were traumatic. So I wasn't like beat up or anything like that, but I was heavily picked on. Like things were thrown at me, things were swiped. You know, I was pushed or tripped or whatever, as much as they could get away with without getting in trouble. The worst part of the bullying was the names. They made fun of my name. They called me all sorts of titles and adjectives that were shameful and hurtful. And the very worst part of the whole bullying experience was that my good friends at the time would always fade to black. They would melt away when the bullying was going down. So I was alone, I was isolated, I felt uncared for, and you know, of course, it's been part of what shaped who I am and all that kind of stuff. And so the isolation, the aloneness being the most hurtful and most painful and most damaging part of all that experience, my plea to all of us is to have eyes that are awake and open to see the bullying that goes on in our kids' lives, our friends' lives, our families' lives, our country, our cities, our market, economy, things like that. And I mention this both because I think it's a general thing to be aware of. I mean, you could think, you know, the president's bullying us. You could think that this other country is bullying us, you know. And so the importance of having a voice and standing together and loving each other and caring for each other, holding hands, not leaving each other when somebody or some group of people is being bullied. And so an example that's recently come to my awareness in the yoga community is Dana Falsetti, F-A-L-S-E-T-T-I. And she's a regular woman, like, so she's a yogi, a yoga teacher, pretty famous, and, you know, on the bigger size. And so she preaches, if you will. She caters, or not caters, that's the wrong word, but like loves, she's body positive. That's the word I want, the words I want. She's body positive, and she gives yoga for everybody. So all types of people and every body, each type of body. She has chair yoga and all these beautiful yoga to include people, to expand the circles, to help more and more people feel healthy, whole, vibrant, alive. And so I mentioned that because she has videos and teachings, and they were on Cody, or are on Cody. And Cody was bought by this bigger company, Aloe Yoga. And Aloe Yoga is very non-body positive and very, like, if you think of the stereotypical yogi, the skinny, massively bendy lady that's super young and pretty, that's what they preach, and that's what they market, and that's who they support and all those things. And so she was like, just like, no big deal. She's like, well, I don't want to be associated with your brand, so can I have my videos back? And, you know, this, it's, you know, I didn't agree to be part of your brand. And then her speaking up about that led to them filing 2 lawsuits in 2 different states. And then being a $1 billion company, they are able to bring just like $100,000 a drop a hat. It's nothing for them, but that like breaks her bank. She doesn't have the money to stand up for herself. And this isn't the first time that they've done this. They have a reputation for bullying and for getting their way using money and power. And so the thing is, though, they also do really great things. They support yoga teachers who really make nothing. I'm a yoga teacher also. We don't make enough to support a family on unless we are a rock star yoga teacher, and there's few and far between. And so they help these people who couldn't otherwise have a good living, have a good living. So that's really good. And they help bring yoga into the awareness. That's really good. So they do positive things. And first and foremost, the people at Aloe are children of God. They're amazing people. They're worthy and belong. and beautiful and all those kinds of things. The thing is, bullying, as I understand it, comes from a lack that's here. It comes from an isolation, a fear, and aloneness. And so then to try and make ourselves, help ourselves feel better about ourselves, we push somebody else down. We control, we get power over others so that we can feel better about ourselves, so that we can calm our anxiety and our fear and our worries and those kinds of things. So my call for us is to love everyone unto fullness, to stand up for the bullied, to love even the bulliers, and to give voice to the wrongs that are going on in our families, our tribes, our communities, our nation, and to stand up for each other and to do it together and to include each other and to love each other. And it, in a lot of ways, it comes down to what Bill and Ted from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure said, and I'm wearing a shirt that says it, if you remember that movie back in the 80s. Be excellent to each other. So that's what my shirt says, and that's my invitation to us, is be excellent to each other. Stand up for each other, have each other's backs, love each other, and have a voice, because your voice matters, against the wrongs in our world, and love each other unto fullness. So be excellent to each other. Much love to you.